Hello and welcome to my devlog. I want to create a game. There are a few reasons why I want to do that. First of all, I want to practice programming because I'm studying software engineering at a German university. And while I'm doing that, I am working as a software engineer in a German IT company, and that's why I want to practice coding in Java especially. In this video I will only create the project and set up the GitHub page and everything. Then I will start code off camera, and sometime in the future I will make another video. I am still unsure if I want to do these videos in English or in German. My native language is German, but my English is good enough to make these videos in English, so I'm unsure. Yeah, as I said, I'm coding with Java and I want to create a game, so I need a library. My library of choice is libgdx. That's because it's documented very well. It has many guides in written and video format. It has many tools and many classes that are really useful, and it's very cross-platform compatible. The caveat is that I have never used it and I don't really know how to use it. I need to learn that while programming. So we are creating a new project. I already made an empty folder. I am unsure how to name the project. I'm just calling it Svarix game. The game class will be called game. So I want to create this project for desktop, Android, iOS and HTML. If I decide that later down the road some of these aren't good enough, like I don't know if I really want to make it runnable on HTML, I might as well uncheck that for now. But I might as well leave it checked and just delete the folder later. The game will be a 2D game. I want to have controller support. I want all the tools because I do know how to use the tools. I use the tools for other projects. Then I want free type. Do I want bullet? Bullet is 3D collision detection. And that's something I don't need because I am in a 2D game. But I will check everything that is 2D. I decided that I will uncheck HTML. In the advanced tab, I want to check IDEA because I will code in IntelliJ IDEA. So save and generate invalid package name. So now it will generate and download all the extensions and the project itself. After that, I can import that to IntelliJ and I will create a new GitHub repository from that. Okay. So the project finished. I will try and create the project now. I will create a new repository on GitHub. I am used to Git, but I never used GitHub. This is a temporary name. I will change it somewhere down the line. As I said, this is my temporary description. I make it private. Maybe I will make it public someday, but not today. Create repository. Finished. Okay, then I will create the new project first. So, I will call this project Svarix game. This is only my project, no template because I don't know how. I will set it private, maybe public later. And I need to refresh the page. Create project. The weird thing is, only the Android folder has the res and assets root, and I don't know why. Where is the main? I think it's in the desktop launcher, right? So if I just run this. There are many warnings. Okay, I need to look into this stuff. That's it for day one, creating my project. So after another day and many hours of trial and error and googling around and creating new projects, I have created like at least 30 projects. I managed to get Android to run properly. and to build properly, as you can see here. I have deleted the repository and made a new one, as you can see here, one commit, and this is the new stuff, and the only commit is first commit where everything was added. And yeah, this is public right now, as is my project. I will start getting into libgdx and trying to get it to work. Ah, and I just noticed that I can't run the iOS build if I don't have a Mac, and that's a problem because I don't have a Mac. I still imported this. I know people who have MacBooks. Maybe I could try and deploy it on iOS when I'm finished with the project and I want to deploy it. That was it for the first beginning. Now I will clean up this these warnings, and I will start getting into libgdx. So, hello and welcome. I don't know what I have talked about in the previous recordings, because that was 1 month ago, or maybe 2 months ago. A lot of time has passed, and in that time I have tried to create new libgdx projects for a week, and I struggled a lot, and I deleted many projects and repositories. Then I wanted to learn libgdx with a tutorial. Wait, I can show the tutorial. I wanted to use this tutorial right here. This might be a good tutorial, but it was way too fast for me and way too complicated for me, and I don't know why. I just didn't really like the tutorial. Maybe I will get into the into parts of the tutorial when I need it, like scene 2D. It's a rough start. Getting into libgdx is very rough. I got motivated this week and I found a German tutorial playlist which explains pretty well what I needed to do, and I am halfway through the playlist. Wait, I can show the playlist. This is the playlist by the Morpheus tutorials. It's in German, so yeah, I don't know if you will need it. I got halfway through to the particle editor and it helped me a lot. I created like one or two new projects, new repositories. I have a code name for the game now. It isn't just the Swerix game, it's now called Project Luna. So as you can see, the project is now called Project Luna and it has way more stuff in it. It has this not shipped assets folder, which I will not include in the final build. These are like zip files for my assets. Yeah, I've included much more code and I've started coding. I got all my assets from this site, GameArt2D. There's this freebie section where you can get free sprites and tile sets, and I have downloaded like all tile sets and all sprite sheets. I don't really need the UI or this. It looks okay. It's my debugging sprite sheets. I will create sprite sheets myself or buy some, or I don't know, but I won't use these in the final version. But yeah, you are all probably very excited to see what I've been working on. I have made like very confusing code. I haven't really programmed my game. I have tried to program something to get into libgdx. That's why nothing here is private and this code is all over the place. And that's why it looks like this. I just wanted to try out everything. So this is my... Why isn't this picture transparent? This picture should be transparent. It was transparent. Like this morning, but that's besides the point. Yeah, I tried text, I tried a map editor. This was in the map editor. This is my sprite sheet, which can be animated if I left click. This is the particle editor. That's a blue flame particle, but the image taken for the particle are kunais, these throwing knives of ninjas. And I usually should turn myself around. I will only turn myself if I press the left click button. I have basic input. I do have some input for other things, like I'm pretty sure I have music. Yeah, I have music that I can pause and unpause and stop. And I have a sound somewhere. There it is. These are sounds I created, so I don't have any copyright issues. This should be very copyright friendly, like the sprites are freebies from the site, and these sounds and music I created myself. I tried out some sounds, some music, the map editor, the sprite sheets, the particle editor, the text. That's why this is all over the place. I even have a second version where I try with menus and different screens. Here it's green and it says press to start, and if I right click, it's white and it says hello, this works. this is what I have. Is this resizable? Hey, this is resizable. I didn't know that. Well, that's all I have for now. I'm really getting into it now. I understand a lot more. I could start in code right now, but I want to learn a bit more stuff, like, for example, how do I do physics properly? Are there better ways to do different screens and menu screens? I want to get into multi-threading and maybe use that. Now that I know more about the stuff and I know what I'm doing, like, a bit, I will watch more tutorials and I will code more. And soon, like in a month or two or earlier, I should start to work on the real game and not on this placeholder stuff. The next videos should have like coding montages or I don't know, time lapses of me coding, just because I wasn't coding that much. I was like watching a video on my second monitor and then writing two lines of code and then watching the video and then writing another two lines. It wasn't that much coding going on. Why? This is transparent. I don't know why this doesn't work. That is a weird error. Sprites Ninja Boy running. What? Oh, because it's small. I changed the... That's annoying. I changed the paths of everything. That's annoying. Okay, let's try again. Launching activity. Okay. I'm ready. Come on. Unfortunately, Project Luna stopped. Why? Oh, because the path isn't right again. I won't only do coding montage. I might do coding streams or streams for making assets. If I like draw pictures or I make music or stuff for the game, I might live stream that. I don't know yet. I might. What is the problem? I changed this path. Can this please just run? Oh, why? Why? Oh, I need to edit the file. Why? Please work. I've done everything I could. What? Oh my lord. Everything here, I want to change to tile sets. Replace all. Can this please run? Please, just run. Just. Please, I want to show that Android is working with no problems. It's working. Yeah, I can't use WASD, but I can use the arrow keys. Yeah, it's working, and I can tap on the screen for running. It's very, very laggy. I don't know if my PC can't handle the Android emulator, or if the Android emulator can't handle the game. But one of the two is happening right now. Yeah, it's pretty bad. I will take care of that, but when I am finishing the game, the finishing touches. And one other thing that I want to show, I have shown that I can accept inputs, music, sounds, pictures, maps, particles, animations. The camera works because I can follow the player. But what I haven't shown is the cheeky little folder that you can see right here, the screenshots folder. I do have a screenshots folder. Why do I have a screenshots folder, you ask? If IntelliJ lets me click on desktop, then I can show you. Here's my screenshots folder. Here's my game. And if I press, I think it's P? No, K? Ah, it's K. You see the game lags a bit? And when I look into this folder, I do have three screenshots with timestamps. I do need these timestamps because I think if I create two screenshots with the same name, they get overwritten. So if I take two screenshots in 1 second, it might end up being only one. Yeah, it's only one, even though I clicked like two or three times. They get overwritten, that's why I have the timestamp in it. And these are proper screenshots of the game. You see? But yeah, that's what I have so far. I have started getting into libgdx. I have practiced a bit. I will watch more tutorials, get more into it, and then start working on the real project. I know this is very, very bad and ugly code, and most of it doesn't serve any purpose, and most of this could be private as well. I know, you don't have to tell me that this everything could be private and that would still work as intended. I'm learning, yeah, this is only code for learning and for nothing else. I will delete like 99% of this code when I start working on the real project. But this was the first video. I just wanted to share my thoughts. Why am I doing this? What am I using? I wanted to take you with me learning libgdx and creating a project and working with GitHub. I have updated my GitHub project, as you can see. So this contains like nodes and IDs here that I added in, and added placeholder textures. I put that in progress because I already added placeholder textures, but I don't know. I don't know why I can't call this done. It's basically done, but I don't know why I wanted to call this in progress. But that was my experience getting into libgdx. I will show you more of the coding side and more of the working on the real project side once I finished all the tutorials. But yeah, see you later. That's because it's documented So we are creating a new project. I already made an empty ordner, empty folder. I will start getting into libgdx. Yeah, it's pretty bad. I will take care of that. But I wanted.